If you use the Photos app that comes with your Mac, then stay tuned because I have an awesome trick to teach you today, which will help show you which of the photos in your Photos library have not already been organized into albums, thus helping you do so. Coming up next on Tech Talk America. So recently I was doing a private lesson with this gentleman, Nate Bennett. Hey, dude, thank you for having this issue. So Nate called me. He had taken a class of mine that I had already taught. If you haven't seen it, I'll give you a link to it. It's totally free down below in the description of the video. And that class is called How to Finally Organize Your Photos Library. And so he told me that he'd kind of taken some of the steps he'd gone through. He'd created some albums, some structure. But then he kind of came to me with this problem of how do I know which of the photos in my library are not already organized? So it kind of took me a minute or two. I did a little quick, you know, Google search, and I came to think, you know what? I bet a lot of other people at home are having that same issue. So if you did, hit that like button. So we're going to go to a quick cut. And when we come back, I'll be on my desktop behind me. All right, folks, so the first step, if you have not already done so, is you need to create that initial structure so that we have a place to put all of your photos into the correct corresponding albums. So if you look here on the left-hand side of my screen, here under where it says My Albums, there's this little plus symbol. So what you just want to do, if you haven't already done so, is to go through here and create new albums and then just title them the way that you would like your photos to be organized. For example, a lot of my clients like to have an album with all of their family photos. Maybe they want another one with different vacations all grouped together. Whatever structure works for you, just create it. Doesn't even matter if there isn't any content in those albums. All you need to do is create the structure. Then when you're done with that, that's where this little search algorithm comes into play. What we're going to do is we're going to really utilize a feature that's built into Photos called a Smart Album to show us all of those photos that are not already organized. So let's go up here to the top left under File, and we're going to go to New Smart Album. Now, of course, you can call this whatever you want. For now, I'm just going to call this Unorganized Pics. Now, below, we're going to just create that little algorithm. So what we're going to do is we're going to change this away from Photo, and we're going to go up here to Album. Then, where it says Is, we're going to change that from Is to Is Not. And this, we're going to leave just the way it is. And you can see right here, it has found 44 photos in my photo library that match that criteria. So let's hit OK. And if you look over here on the left-hand side, there is now a new Smart Album called Unorganized Pics. And so now I can go through here and let's say I want to take this photo right here and I want to now organize it. I'm going to put it into an album. So this is one of my droning Provincetown videos, still images from one of my videos. So I'm going to just drop it into that album and you'll notice that when I do so, it disappears from this list. So one of the things that I think is a secondary benefit is just the pure gratification that you are going to get as you see this number at the very top of my screen start to go down. Because what's awesome about this is that now that we have syncing ability, you know, if you use the photo library feature in iCloud so that it does sync all of your photos across your various devices, what's awesome about this is that you could go into this Smart Album on any of your devices and just when you have some free time, just move a few photos, move them into this album, move them into that album, and before you know it, this number will be, well, hopefully less than it is currently. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. I do hope you enjoyed this class. If you did, I really do greatly appreciate it. If you just take a moment, maybe leave me a little comment down below, hit that like button, share me on whatever social media platform you're using these days. And also keep in mind that if you out there would ever like to do a private lesson with yours truly, I know it might sound silly to some people that a YouTube guy, why would you do private lessons? Well, the fact of the matter is that I do all of this here from my second bedroom in my home. And it's cool. I get to have a lot of fun doing it. It's really cool for me to get to be able to affect so many different businesses and educators and students and all different sorts of different people globally. But at the same time, there is a part of me that really loves getting to hear your stories and work with you. So if you would ever care to take a little private lesson with yours truly, as of today's date, I have the pricing set at $150 an hour. I'm going to try to keep it as reasonable as I possibly can. If you would like to do so, all the information is on my website, techtalkamerica.com/private lessons. Thanks for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.